Good morning, everyone, and a Happy New Year to you all. Thank you for joining this act of worship from St Andrew's, Bushey Heath, Carpenters Park and South Oxhey, and Bushey and Oxhey Methodist Churches. The theme of the service this morning is New Beginnings, and I look forward to hearing our minister's thoughts on this subject throughout the service. Let us therefore begin with a short prayer. Lord God, we come to you in this holy season of Christmas and continue to celebrate the mystery of your coming in Jesus. As we begin this act of worship, we remember the danger following your birth and the flight of the Holy Family into Egypt as refugees. You came into a real world with real dangers to make real a God who is with his people always. As we worship you now, may we be conscious of your presence with us, so that we can view the future with confidence, so that it may truly be a time of new beginnings as we enter a new year, secure in the knowledge that God is with us. Amen.
The reading this morning comes from the book of Psalms, and it's Psalm 8, to the leader according to the Gittith, a psalm of David. O Lord, our sovereign, how majestic is your name in all the earth. You have set your glory above the heavens. Out of the mouths of babes and infants you have founded a bulwark because of your foes to silence the enemy and the avenger. When I look at your heavens, the work of your fingers, the moon and the stars that you have established, what are human beings that you are mindful of them, mortalistic that you care for them? Yet you have made them a little lower than God and crowned them with glory and honour. You have given them dominion over the works of your hands. You have put all things under their feet, all sheep and oxen, and also the beasts of the field, the birds of the sea and the fish of the sea, whatever passes along the paths of the sea. O Lord, our sovereign, how majestic is your name in all the earth. This is the word of the Lord. Thanks be to God.
I Reading from Revelation chapter 21, verses 1 to 6. Then I saw a new heaven and a new earth, for the first heaven and the first earth had passed away, and the sea was no more. And I saw the holy city, the new Jerusalem, coming down out of heaven from God, prepared as a bride adorned for her husband. And I heard a loud voice from the throne saying, See, the home of God is among mortals. He will dwell with them. They will be his peoples, and God himself will be with them. He will wipe away every tear from their eyes. Death will be no more. Mourning and crying and pain will be no more, for the first things have passed away. And the one who was seated on the throne said, See, I am making all things new. Also he said, Write this, for these words are trustworthy and true. Then he said to me, It is done. I am the Alpha and the Omega, the beginning and the end. Thanks be to God for his word.
Right, here we go. 6th of January. Time to take the decorations down. We need to pack away this last Christmas. There's a sense in which we've only just arrived. We've only just got to the manger. Let's stay a while. Let's linger. Let's ponder on this mystery. Let's make sense of this part of the story. And you know, life needs some colour at the moment. We need a bit of sparkle. Let's leave the tree and the decorations up. Forget the Twelfth Night and all that. And officially, we can keep them up until Candlemas. Why not? Why not? Let's stay at the stable. But you know, Mary and Joseph couldn't stay. They had no choice. However cosy that scene is in that stable, they had to flee. Herod, in his jealous rage, declared that all baby boys would be killed. The Holy Family had to flee. So once again, it was down to Egypt. It's amazing how often in our faith story that happens. Egypt becomes this place of refuge. It's a place of Moses. It's a place of Joseph. And now it's a place of Mary and Joseph and Jesus. And you know, 2,000 years on, and in 2022, people are still having to flee for their lives. Still having to look for those safe havens. Happy New Year, Happy New Year, the ABBA song goes. Imagine yourself standing in front of the door that says 2022. How do you approach that door? Are you one of those people that go straight through? You can't wait to get into this new year. You want to see what this year's got in store. You're keen to embrace the future. Or do you hesitate? Tiny steps. Reluctantly turning the door handle. Proceed with caution. You know, we don't know what this year has got in store for us. We don't know what it's going to be like this year. And I'm really having to work through what it means to live with uncertainty. I'm reaching the third stage of stationing matching. And it's a bit daunting living with uncertainty. I don't know where my ministry in 2022 is going to be at this point. It's not easy when you like being in control. I suppose this is where the covenant prayer becomes real. I'm trying hard not to think about the what if. But it's through that door, trusting and believing that God is in this. You know, we stand at the door of this new year, 2022. We're days in. We don't know what the future has in store. But I want us to do three things today. One, last look back. What did we take from last year? What did we discover about ourselves? What did we discover about God? The second thing is, what do we want to do different this year? What changes do we feel we need to make? And finally, let's embrace 2022, whatever comes our way, whatever this year has in store. For we know we don't enter this year alone. We go with a God who's been there, who is there, and will walk with us this next part of the journey. God bless. Amen.
God of new beginnings, hear our prayers. We bring before you ourselves at the beginning of this new year. We bring before you our worries and our joys, our grief and our hopes. God of new beginnings, hear our prayers. We bring before you all those for whom the new year is frightening or miserable, those who are recently bereaved and face a future missing a friend, partner, or family member. We bring before you those with medical needs, facing treatment or surgery, or are waiting for treatment because of COVID. God of new beginnings, hear our prayers. We bring before you those who are stepping out into something new, those starting a new job, retirement, those who have moved house, or who have made life choices that mean a major change. We pray for those for whom a change or a new beginning is difficult because of a mental health condition, autism, or anxiety. We bring before you those who are stepping out into something joyfully new, the arrival of a new baby, an exciting opportunity, a success, or a long-awaited holiday. God of new beginnings, hear our prayers. We bring before you those who face challenges caused by poverty, natural disaster, violence, political unrest and repression, addiction, abuse, and injustice. God of new beginnings, hear our prayers. We bring before you all those whom we love and care about, and ask your blessing, your healing, and your grace to be poured out on each one of them. God of new beginnings, hear our prayers. Amen.
Can I take this opportunity to wish you a very happy new year, all the best for 2022. Thank you to all those who've taken part in today's service. Thanks to those who've read. those who've welcomed and those who've prayed with us. Thanks to Ken for piecing all this together. And thank you for sharing in this act of worship. And a final blessing for this new year. We stand to face the future. God behind us in the past. Christ before us, the way ahead. Christ beside us in this moment. Christ beneath us in our weakness. Christ above us to shield us. Beneath the shadow of his wings, we are safe. Christ between us to bind us in the unity of his love. Christ in us, equipping us with his all-sufficient grace. Thus, armed, guided and protected, we face the new year. Now we arise and go forth on the journey before us, knowing that where Christ leads, life is a journey home. Therefore we travel in faith, in hope and in love. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. May the blessing of God, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit be upon us, and upon all this year, and to all eternity. Amen. Take care, and God bless.